Imagine that you're following a recipe to make cookies. The recipe states that you're supposed to add in 2 of sugar. 2 what? Do you add 2 teaspoons? 2 cups? 2 cubes? The resulting cookie would be very different depending on which unit of measurement was used. Units of measurement are used to describe objects. They can describe the size of an object, like a tree that is 5 meters in height, or a flower that's 5 centimeters. The weight of an object, 4 kilograms versus 4 grams, or the volume of an object, 1 liter of water or 1 milliliter of water. They can also be used to describe countless other aspects of matter. So, if we were to look at the size of organisms on Earth, what unit of measurement would we use? Scientists use the metric system, which includes meters to measure length or height. For example, a blue whale is about 30 meters in length. A human is about 1.8 meters tall. Another common unit of measurement is centimeters. Centimeters are 100 times smaller than meters. To get a better idea of the scale of a centimeter, let's zoom into this hummingbird. Notice that the measurement scale has changed to centimeters. A common size for hummingbirds is about 8 centimeters in length. Millimeters are 10 times smaller than centimeters. Let's zoom in further to look at the scale of millimeters. Ants are around 5 to 10 millimeters in length. Micrometers are 1,000 times smaller than millimeters. Single cells are often measured in micrometers. A human skin cell is about 30 micrometers in diameter, while bacterial cells range in size from 0.5 to 5 micrometers. Micrometers are extremely small. In fact, you would need a microscope to see something that small. Nanometers are even smaller, at 1/1000th of a micrometer. Viruses are measured in nanometers. The Ebola virus is about 970 nanometers in length, so almost a micrometer, but only 80 nanometers in diameter. Other viruses can be even smaller. They are so small that they require special electron microscopes to view.